Hello there and welcome, I'm glad you could make it on this trip to one of Britain's deadliest places. Now keep your wits about you in this strange and distant land as we go on a quest to find the great British land. A couple housekeeping tips I need to quickly mention. Please don't flash photography, you'll only draw attention. Soak yourself in aftershave and use it as a mask, and put this skin tight t-shirt on to act as camouflage. Now that's all been covered, we're ready to get started. There's a pack of lads now, just look at their markings. Their unique tattoos differ them from rival gangs. A bunch of Chinese symbols and a couple tribal bands. There's six of them in total, and though they're mostly social, they're likely to attack another pack if they're not local. They operate collectively and often have a tendency to urinate in public places just to mark their territory.
Welcome to the jungle, it's a hostile terrain, a dangerous location full of predators and prey. It may not seem that way to you, especially in the day, but when night falls, it turns into a very different place.
Let's take a closer look at this group in particular. Hands up anybody here who knows this bit of trivia. What two traits does the alpha male exhibit? Yes, you at the back.
He's the loudest and the biggest.
Correct. Now in this group, Gab is the leader, and he's in charge of all the beta males who are weaker. When it comes to where to go, he makes the selection, and when he cracks a joke, they all laugh without exception. The female of the species also has degrees of status, but their rank is measured on a slightly different basis. The queen bee is usually the one who's most attractive, so being alpha lad comes with another big advantage. The system is accepted and must always be respected, as failure to comply can cause a lad to get ejected. This might not seem fair to you, and I agree it isn't, but out here in the jungle, it's survival of the fittest.
Welcome to the jungle, it's a hostile terrain, a dangerous location full of predators and prey. It may not seem that way to you, especially in the day, but when night falls, it turns into a very different place.
Now I know that you came here for one main reason, to see the British lad during mating season. And now that he's drunken up, it only seems right to try and find a partner to take home for the night. There's more men than women, which is always the way, so they engage in a complex courtship display. This can range from anything from dancing and posing to telling her about the kind of car that he's owning. Don't look now, but I think we've got a match. Gav spotted Tracy and she thinks he's a catch. They're grinding on the dance floor, but just before they leave, they're greeted by her ex-mating partner called Steve. Neither will back down, so a violent fight ensues, where everything from foreheads to beer bottles are used. Steve is victorious, so on this occasion, Gav goes home with a kebab to watch Base Station.
Welcome to the jungle.